done 30-minute full body workout with no jumping. This workout also requires zero equipment. All you need is yourself. Make sure you can see your screen so you can follow along with me. And without further ado, let's get to it. All right, guys, we're going to start off with a warm-up, beginning with our neck, turning the head from side to side. Press those shoulders down. Turn the head as far as you can over each shoulder. Alright, next we're going to warm up our wrists because we are going to be on the ground just using our body weight today in some plank position, so it's really important that we warm up those wrists. So I'm just kind of moving my wrists in like a figure eight motion here. Good, and stretch them out. Fingertips on top of the palm. Other hand. Good. Next up, ankles. Rolling one foot outward. Good. And switch directions inward. Good, switching directions, rolling it inward. Good, and forwards. Good, next up, warming up our hamstrings. Your light on your toes, moving from side to side, kicking your booty. Take a body weight squat, down, and up, squat. So bracing your core as you come down. Portion. Each of these exercises are going to be 45 seconds on with a 15 second rest. And we're going to work in two. So we'll do two exercises at a time, repeat those, and then move on. First up, fingertips are by the ears. We're going to start off nice and strong. You're going to come down, down on your knees, up, up. But as you come up, you're going to bring that second leg up for a crunch. Down, up, crunch. Take this slow if you have to. Thinking about your core. Press through that supporting heel to stand up. Use that glute. Good work, 15 second rest. Our second exercise is a narrow squat. So you're gonna do a narrow squat, and then you're gonna step it back for a reverse lunge. So, squat, up, lunge, back to center. Squat, other leg. Make sure you're hitting all three positions, sitting back into that lunge, and then pressing through your supporting heel. Again, starting off with our knee down to our standing crunch. Remember that you can take this and any exercise as slow as you need to. That's the beauty of doing timed intervals, is you can make this as intense or as slow paced as you need. Make sure when you're driving that knee up, you're bringing it up and forward and meeting that elbow in the center, so you're feeling that crunch. Squat to lunge. Make sure you're getting that booty all the way down in your squat. Keep your chest lifted. Good work. Moving on to our next set of exercises, coming down to the ground. Nice and simple. We're just doing straight glute bridges. So on your back, bringing your heels in closer to your booty, tucking the pelvis under, pressing your lower back to the floor, sending the hips up, squeezing those glutes, and lower. Holding that same pelvic position as you press those hips up. So don't arch your back here as you're sending the hips up. Keep the pelvis tucked under. Good, we're gonna stay down here on the ground. Next up, we're gonna do some leg drops. So there's some different variations that you can do depending on how intense you wanna make this. You can tuck those hands underneath the booty, drop the legs, keep them bent, tap the heels on the floor, bring them up. Like so, that's a little bit easier. Or keep them straight, bring them up. Or crunch with your upper body and drop. Bring it up, but your lower back should be pressed to the floor the entire time, no matter what variation you are doing. You shouldn't be lifting the booty up to step. Your whole upper body and torso should be still and straight. Stand up.
Here we go, nice and still.
Again, take this as slow as you need to. It does not need to be pretty. I just want you to focus on your core. So you should really be feeling your core as you're reaching to stand up and as you stand up. Don't forget to control on your way down as well. Down to the ground. hard work, I know those are tough. All right, last set of exercises. You're going to do a sumo squat with the racks. That's your first exercise. Second exercise, you're going to go down to the ground for some push-ups. So legs are wide, down as you come up, squeeze those inner thighs all the way up from the toes. Doing those squats, it's very easy to just kind of go through the movement of these, but I really want you to focus on form. Sinking your booty down, pressing through these heels, coming up, squeezing those inner thighs all the way up on the toes. Hips feel nice and heavy, sinking down into the mat. Good, and pressing back. You're gonna reach from side to side. So you're gonna bring that left hand over top of your right. Moving through center, then to the other side. Moving through center, rolling up nice and slow. You're going to step your left foot forward. You're going to come into a high lunge, pressing the hips forward. On the mat, we're going to switch legs, bring the right leg forward. Left hip is pressing forward, and you're also sinking deep into this lunge. On your bum, extending the legs out long, bringing your right leg over top of your left, sitting up nice and tall, driving that right hip down into the floor. In towards your chest and twist, sending the left hip down into the floor. Good, release that leg. You can come up to your knees, or you can do this in a seated position. We're just going to stretch out the lower shoulders. We did lots of planking today. Send that shoulder down. Swing those arms up a couple times and bring the left arm over. This 30-minute full body workout with no jumping. If you did, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and let me know how you did in the comments down below. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button, turn on your post notifications so you don't miss another video from me, and I will see you guys very soon. Bye!